Hey guys, welcome to Gardening Upbeat, and I hope you are doing really very well. Now in this video, I am going to give you a few very simple tricks to get maximum flowers on your Zerbera plants similar to the one you are looking right now. So I am going to take you a few days back and I am going to show you the exact things I did with my plants. Please also note that I am also going to show you the best fertilizers for the Zerbera plants, and this video includes updates of more than 10 months. So let's start the video now. This is how my Zerbera plants were looking almost 40 days back, and you can see that they were looking absolutely unhealthy. I got them at the seedling stage, and first I planted them in 2018. At that time, they were looking something like this. Since they were looking bad, I decided to do few things so that I can revive them, and at the same time, I can also enjoy lots of flowers. So let me show you all the things step by step. The first important thing is to select the best pot to grow your Zerbera plants. For Zerbera plants, it's better if we can use a pot something like this. As you are looking, the depth of the pot is near about 8 inch and it's 12 inch wider. Now you may be asking why we need this kind of pot. The answer is, see, Zerbera plants spread really very well, and that's why if you use a pot where it's much wider, it's going to give you a much better look. The second important thing is to use the best potting soil mix. So here you can see my soil potting soil mix already ready, and I have three different components in equal part, where one part is normal garden soil, second part is vermicompost, and the last part is cocopeat. There is one more component which we need, and that is the perlite. Now I know how much amount I should add to the potting soil mix, but I know that you may get confusion like how much percentage you should add. So let me give you an example. So you can consider all this soil mix as 80% and then add 20% perlite to the soil mix. Now I can say that this is the best potting soil mix for the Zerbera plants. If you haven't tried it, please try it once, and I know that you would also get the similar result. Now here you can see I am trying to compact the soil with full force, but it's not getting compacted. And that's why the Zerbera plants would be able to spread really very fast, and they would be also growing well. If you take a look at the soil in my previous pot, you can see that the soil is looking really very hard, and if we use similar kind of soil, Zerbera plants won't be able to spread that fast. At the time of planting the same Zerbera seedlings, I used good soil mix, but problem is the soil in any pot become too compact after, let's say, 1 year or 2 years. And that's why it's always a good idea to change the soil at least once in a 2 year, or it's much better if you can change the soil once in a year. For time being, we need to do these two things the right way. The first one is selecting a good pot, and second one is preparing the best potting soil mix for Zerbera plants. The next important thing is to fertilize our plants on regular basis, which I am going to show you after a few minutes. Before that, let me just repot both of my plants in the same pot. So guys, this is the result after 40 days, and like you have seen it already, they are blooming really very well. I did not apply any kind of fertilizers in last 40 days, and now let me show you the best fertilizers for the Zerbera plants. For that, we have to move forward 10 plus months. So let's do that. After 10 months, this is how Zarbera plants are looking. In the summer, I actually lost one plant due to the continuous and heavy rainfall. Zarbera plants actually don't prefer the soil to be consistently wet, and due to the continuous rainfall, one plant could not survive. It's time to fertilize my plants so that this year also I can enjoy lots of blooms. And whatever footage you have seen in the previous part of the video, all those were recorded in the last winter. Before applying the fertilizers, please remove the surrounding soil, and you can remove, let's say, 1/2 inch to 1 inch. Next, we are going to add three different components. First one is 20 grams of mustard cake powder. Basically, it contains lots of protein, and if you don't have mustard cake powder, you can apply either fish emulsion fertilizers or blood meal. The second component is one handful of bone meal. So we can say I am applying roughly 50 grams of bone meal. Instead of bone meal, you can use rock phosphate, and it's available on Amazon. The third component is 1 teaspoon of Epsom salt. Please note that 1 teaspoon is almost equal to 5 grams, and I would like to inform you one very important thing. See the amount of fertilizers whatever I am applying, it's because I am using a huge pot, and if you are using smaller pot, please decrease the amount of fertilizers. That's it, and next cover the fertilizers with some fresh potting soil mix, and this is the exact thing I am doing. You can apply the same fertilizers once in 30 to 40 days and you would get good result. Other than this, there is no need to apply any other kind of fertilizers, but still, if you want, you can apply the micronutrients once in 25 to 30 days. One example of a fertilizer that contains all the micronutrients is the flower booster from Trash Basket. Finally, it's time to water, and my assistant is helping me to do that. Other than all the things whatever I have shown you here, please also do two other things properly. The first one is watering at the right time, and water only when you see the topsoil is looking dry. The second one is sunlight, and please try to provide them at least 5 to 6 hours of direct sunlight if you are expecting lots of flowers on your plants. So guys, these are the things that you need to do to enjoy lots of flowers on your Zarbera plants. Now you have already seen what I got last year, I mean heavy flowers on my Zarbera plants, and if you want to see this year blooms, then you can join me on Instagram. There I usually post the picture of my plants and flowers and all other things. I truly hope that you found the video useful, and if you did, please don't forget to like the video, share it, and subscribe to my channel if you are new to Gardening Upbeat. Thank you very much for watching the video. I truly appreciate it. Have a great time and enjoy.